Today we're talking about turkey shotguns for youth. We have one here, and he has some experience in turkey hunting. And in fact, that's his turkey gun over yonder. When you're talking about turkey guns for youth, you have limited options because you have to be concerned about recoil. And even if a child can stand a lot of recoil, this one would shoot a 30-06 level recoil when he was 4 or 5 years old. You have to be concerned about that because you don't want him to get punchy. You know, you don't want him to get brain damage, which is actually a thing with youngsters and shooting high recoil guns. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to have Rex handle the guns and figure out which ones he likes best out of them. The guns we've picked are based on the fact that for a 410, you can buy a factory low recoil load. A 20 gauge is fairly easy to hand load for low recoil. And then a 12 gauge, if you're hunting at short range over decoys with a blind, like a lot of people like to do with kids, then you can use a regular bird load, and the gun will be heavy enough that if you support it, then they can use it, and you've got a low recoil option right there, what you already have. Not really an option for us, because we hunt old school. We don't believe in blinds and decoys. That's right.
Because if we use decoys, they might be concerned about how they don't move.
But we don't use decoys because it's cheap, and we don't play with dolls. We big boys.
Mm-hmm.
No dollies. All right, so it's kind of your show. Let's start off with a full-size 20 gauge. Just like you've been turkey hunting. How hard is that to hold? Now, you won't be able to manipulate it, but that safety, you're accustomed to that because you use that gun over there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. This gun will kick less than your gun because it's heavier. But this gun will kick less than his gun because it's heavier, but you would have to do your own load. Now, this is a 410. You have to cock the hammer on it. So I want you to cock the hammer. Practice that. Hard to reach, huh? Get your hand up there and reach it then. Uh-huh. When I was your age, besides not pointing at people's feet, I would get my thumb up here and use my whole hand. Doing that in the turkey woods. Yeah, you cocked it eventually. We ain't doing that in the turkey woods. That one's out. Now these old guns like this are good because this is a solid chunk of steel right here. And it's going to kick less.
Because it's heavy.
Than a 410 with a light frame.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about this gun, Rex?
Well, it's a good gun. And I tried shooting a Jake with it. The only fact is I missed because I looked up after shooting.
Yeah.
I can hold this for a long time. It's light. It's just if I hold it too much, my arm might hurt. But this is a light gun.
He said it's a light gun and he can hold it fine. I find this an easy gun to miss with because it's so light you can pull it off target easily. Another reason is a 410 with a turkey choke has a very tight pattern. It's a little easier to miss with. And after he missed one with this gun, I set him up with a light load on his 20 gauge over under.
Mm-hmm.
Go on and see how you like that compared to that 410 you just tried. Now get it in on the meat in here, not out on the bone, get it on the meat. If you take these little guns and you pull them in tight, it's just going to rock you. It ain't going to punch you. How you feel about that?
Yeah, if I set it here and I push it into me, push it, it barely moves that much.
Sure. But how about that gobbler the other morning? No, I'm talking about you're nice and steady right now. How was that gobbler the other morning?
excited, and I was so excited that my gun was shaking. And when you told me to turn off the safety, before I even got my hand to it, it moved.
Well, do you think this would offer you any advantages in that situation? Would this gun be any better than that one in that situation?
Well, that, it probably wouldn't be shaking.
It'd shake all over the place. It'd shake worse than that.
Well, yeah, because this is heavy and it anchors, and this is light.
So, try them both and see which one you can hold steadier.
Let's hold them pretty steady. That just shakes a little bit more.
A little more shaky, and then when you get the gobbler fever again, that one's going to be a little steadier for you.
Yep.
I don't really know, man. That's really up to you. Now, here's a 12 gauge. Not really appropriate for what we do because there's nothing to help him hold it up. We move around in the woods and we set up and call the turkey to us, which I'm able to do just fine with Rex. We've had good success with it. He's seen, I couldn't tell you how many at this point.
When I was younger and I shot this gun, I saw a lot of jakes.
We called up about a half dozen jakes and a couple gobblers.
Yeah, I saw them.
Then we've called up, and other times we've also called up turkeys and not shot at them, or, well, we ain't exactly figured out the best one for Rex yet. Now, this one is a 12-gauge pump. We can put a light load in it, a dove load, and kill one at 20 yards. It's not really going to be a problem. A heavy dove load, a pheasant load, is going to be too much kick. You want to stay around an ounce or less. Close to about 1,100 foot per second as you can get. And that'll kill one at 20 yards. It'll make him flop real good. You run out there. So what do you reckon about that?
It's
I don't think that's going to work. No. Now, if I set it up on some kind of tripod or something, then you'd be able to handle it. But we just don't do that. I'm not carrying a tripod.
And my arm isn't long enough to fully reach this.
Well, you don't necessarily have to reach that, but if you get behind it, it's going to kick you in the hand. All right, fine. All right, this gun's about 7 1/4 pounds. This gun is about 6 1/4, 5, 3.3, and 5.6 pounds. So we maxed out at about 6 pounds. And he knows the length of the stock didn't bother him too much. It just kind of gets a little further out on the shoulder. Low recoil, that's fine. So now we have picked, give me your top two or three that you would consider for turkey.
Well, I would most consider this because it's a nice gun. You could put a light load in it, like you said. And the second one I would suggest is this. You just need a more steady hold on it.
I will add to that, that gun kicks about like a 30-06 or better with a turkey load in. I don't call that light recoil, but he was shooting it at 5. If you limit your practice, maybe. What else you got?
Well, this is a nice gun. It's just long and long for me, and it's hard to hold.
It's heavy.
It's heavy. It's a heavy gun.
It's got more stuff out here. It's basically a double barrel plus, and then they're big thick barrels, as opposed to, because that's 24-inch barrels and that's 20-inch barrel, but they're bigger and thicker, so it's got more weight out front.
Mm-hmm. Look because if the barrel is bigger out front, that means it's going to kind of lay down.
Okay. Now, what about this? If you didn't have to cock the hammer, what about this?
That would be a nice gun because it's, well, I'm pretty sure I can reach the trigger.
We'll try it again.
Yeah, I can reach the trigger.
Okay, if you use that 410 with that steel hump receiver with a turkey load in it, it's significantly less recoil than this lightweight. This one is ultra light, kicks like an aught-6. This one weighs as much as a 20 gauge, and it's going to be a fairly decent recoil. So compared to your 20 gauge, how do you like this one?
That's a nice gun. I've never shot before, but if the hammer were a little bit down, I could probably kill a turkey with it.
Well, the thing about it is that when we turkey hunt, this is not how we sit. He sits right here. So, if you had a kid turkey hunting with it and it's time to cock it, well, you have to do it for him. What you have to do is pull the trigger, pull the hammer, let the trigger out, let the hammer out, and then it's quiet. Mm-hmm. And then you've controlled that the same as you would control a safety, and you're right here on him so you can keep him out of trouble. So this would be an option. All right, so what are your top three, if you had to pick them?
So, this, these are all nice guns. That's heavy. This is light. I could shoot a turkey with it.
You couldn't handle that. I don't know why we're even talking about that one. That's out. You can't handle it. It's too heavy.
Yeah. It's heavy, but it would probably kill a turkey.
It would certainly kill a turkey, but we're talking about what gun is going to work best for you.
Well, I'm actually going to back this gun. The 95, I handled this good.
But it's shakier.
Mm-hmm, because it's lighter.
Get your brain damage.
Yeah. When a gun is lighter, it'll kick more. But if it's heavier, it'll do a small kick.
Okay, so we've said these two. If you had to pick one of these to use, which would you pick?
Probably this one.
Okay. So, what we've got here is our only low recoil option is a heavy 410 with a steel receiver. And this would weigh in a 410 if you wanted a repeater. Then your youth semi-auto and double barrel 410s weigh about that. And then you can use a factory turkey load for 410. If you want to use a 20 gauge or 28 gauge, which can be had at this weight, then you need to hand load or find someone to load for you. That double barrel 20 gauge over there, with the load I make for them at 7/8 of an ounce, it's about 1,000 foot per second. It's very pleasant to shoot. and it's good to 40 yards. I don't know why I don't hunt with it, really. So these are our top three. I didn't ask you beforehand, but would you be kind enough to shoot these guns for us?
Sure.
Okay. So now we're going to demonstrate the top three shooting them. Okay, we're going in order clockwise on the target from lowest supposed recoil to heaviest. And you can tap out whenever you want. It's best if you don't shoot too much recoil. Work your way up to it. We haven't followed that advice. But that's what I'd recommend to anybody else. Get in the firing position and get comfortable, and I'll cock the hammer for you. Tell me when you want the hammer cocked. Up here in the meat. You tell me when you want it cocked.
I got it when you can cock it.
Huh?
I got it safe so you can cock it.
I will cock it. Just let me do that. Here we go. Shoot the top left dot.
Let's see how we did with that.
No, we're going to shoot them in order and then go look.
Oh.
huh? We've got a 20 gauge, 5.6 pounds with a 3/4 ounce load. This gun has a full choke. You get the other top dot. Top left dot, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why we're going counterclockwise. We said we're going clockwise. Alright. If you had enough, you want some more. You want to shoot the next one.
Okay.
Do you?
Yeah.
Alright. Put it in the meat. In here. Not out on the bone. Me.
That one's going to have the hardest 3/4 because it's like
that. It will. If you don't want to shoot it, you don't have to. If you want to shoot it, shoot it. Entirely up to you. Pull it in tight. Bottom dot. Fire when ready.
Okay, that wasn't hard recoil.
It wasn't.
Dude, when I was 5, that was hard.
You like shooting this guy, dude. He likes guns that kick for some reason. I don't.
That gun doesn't feel like it kicked.
Okay, well let's go down to the target. Go to the target and discuss what you reckon. Now, you, in terms of what he hit, this was a single barrel 410 with no red dot. He hit high and right. You could miss a turkey's head at that range.
With my own gun, I hit about here, so I could kill turkey with it.
Dead bird, bead sight, which is good with a kid because they can't break it, especially a Rex. And then the other 410, you did real good.
Yep.
So yet again, that 410 is tough. But with a red dot, he hit it good. And then, of course, his 20 gauge, he did well with it. Now, give us your thoughts. Yell at the camera and tell us what you think.
Well, on the 410, I think it's a good gun because you can kill turkey with it. It's just I missed high because it was getting a little wobbly when I was waiting for Dad to cock the hammer.
Got tired with it.
Yep.
So
don't hold it for too long or else your kid might miss the turkey.
You hold it, longer you hold it, the wobblier it gets. You need to go ahead and shoot.
Yep. My 20 gauge is a pretty good shot. That would kill one of the turkeys. And you could get them. Make your own light load for them and they could shoot it. And for the other 410, it's a nice gun. It doesn't feel like it kicks anymore. I suggest you could get one of those too because it's light and your kid might not know that the lighter it is, it might have harder recoil. They might just think it's light and be like, well, it's easier to carry.
Alright, well, the 410 is your only option for a factory load, so that would be the top recommendations because you can just buy ammo. Don't choke it too tight because 410 loads are touchy. That's why I still reload ours even though there's factory loads available, because it's pretty obvious you got to be precise in everything to make it work as well as it can. But people I know and an awful lot of other people have good luck with those factory loads, so don't be shy of them. 20 gauge is kind of off the list unless you hand load. So I would say what we found is 410. And I guess lighter works better for Rex, but Rex doesn't appear to mind being kicked. So your top recommendation is?
I don't really know. They're all good guns.
We're going turkey hunting tomorrow. Which one are you going to tote?
I might try with the 410 again.
All right, that's a yield is. It's been customized with a custom choke from Some Toy down in Jessup, Georgia. It has also got a red dot mount from Mr. William down there. And I put a Burris Fast Fire 3 on it. And then, of course, the loads I make are a little better than what you can get factory, but I believe Browning and Federal currently offer TSS loads, which is what you need, TSS. And I saw a stack of them on the shelf at Bass Pro the other day, so this stuff's all available. You just need a little lead time to send your stuff off to Jessup and get it back again. All right, well, that was the Dirt Road Grocery Store. We appreciate you hanging out with us. And don't be scared to get out there with those kids. You don't need decoys in a blind. You just call them up like normal, and it'll be fine. Bye, y'all.
Bye.
Keep on the sunny side.